Hey folks, Alamandic MandicReally here. If I asked you what the inside of the 3D printing nerd studio looked like, would you be able to tell me? Sure, you can picture his backdrop, his desk, but what about the rest of his studio? That's where I'm heading right now.
Like you said, my version of therapy is different than yours.
And what if I said we were ruining a meme by going and building a Voron with a 3D printing nerd? I'm heading the Pacific Northwest and I'm taking you with me. Let's get to Seattle. And just like that, we're in the 3D printing nerd studio. Traveling via transition is the only way to travel. It is vastly superior to hanging out at an airport, getting on a jet plane, flying across the country, getting into a rental car, driving from one state to another just to get here. Anyway, let's take a look around the studio.
Okay, starting off at the front door in the studio here.
Front door, back door, indoor, outdoor, spinning. It says exit, but that's only when going that way. When going this way, it's the entrance. We will start, how about this? We'll go to this side first because it's where I usually go. A&B cameras are set up. I've got a GoPro over there for when I need to time-lapse something. This is the main studio area. I usually there's not a big old Voron on the desk, but I'll stand behind here and wave my arms around and shout at the camera that's right behind you. I've got a couple lights up to either side. Beautiful woodwork on the ceiling. Part of the reason why I got this space is because it just has this uniqueness to it. Filament wall over here. This is the Repcord rep rack system. I got the tubing here with these are the wood cut ones. And then I used the 3D printed French cleats for the back. Over here, you can see I've got lots of prints that I kind of save. A lot of Photos Mint stuff. There's Maxi Figs, Pickle Rick. Over here are more prints that you've probably seen in other episodes. So we've got the 3D printed speakers. There's the Hairy Lion, my first viral video there. Stuff. We have 3D printers, so we have stuff. What's really cool behind here is the secret passage to the print farm. Follow me. Watch your head. In here, this is the print farm. I have 18 different Prusa i3 Mark 3S Plus 3D printers. And this is where we do a lot of print jobs. It used to be kind of Etsy focused with Cinderwing 3D and Flexi Factory and those kind of models. In fact, I still have some that I'm going to sell at deep discounts. But right now, what I'm trying to do is batch and contract manufacturing. For example, 3D Chameleon, they use parts that I've made. Alex Lind has made the Hat Cat, and he's had parts ordered from me. Daniel Boyer, she has the Steam Connection. And I think, Alan, you actually got me doing a print job stuff earlier. Yeah.
Insert here.
That's the print farm.
That's 3D printing.
The print farm, it always goes. Yeah, this was a quick print. It was 70 buttons. So a friend of ours works for a school district and they needed accessible buttons. And they asked if I could do it. And I was like, of course I can do it. And so we got to print them in. Well, all sorts of really cool colors. Buttons and pieces and all that kind of stuff. So I'm just, there were two pieces that broke during the printing process. They didn't print at a quality that I thought was okay. And so we got to the very end of it, needed 70 of them. And so I just need two small pieces and one smaller piece. Print time 59 minutes and then the print job is done. Also handy, this type of tool here, this flat, what is this? This is a, like an artist's knife, an artist's spatula kind of thing. It's really thin. You can sharpen the tip just a little bit and it lets you get under any sort of piece that's going to stick to that bed a little too much. Oh, it's almost therapeutic.
Your idea of therapy and mine are different.
Yeah. So a fun story, that used to be the resin room and it stunk a lot. It made me sneeze and we cleaned it up and you'll see the new resin room later. So directly opposite of the indoor, outdoor, incoming, outgoing door is a closet. And it's not, I mean, it's a friggin' closet. Like who cares, right? But if you you remember, I did prints for Neil Patrick Harris. I made a really big frame. Two of them, in fact, to go on some, to have some paintings on that he had. There were two frames. I printed the parts for three, just in case there was something that went wrong.
And so I have a full Neil Patrick Harris frame, all in parts back here. And I'd like some suggestions on what I should do with it. Should I auction it off? Should I give it away? Should I paint it myself? I don't know, but I have those. And so I thought that's kind of a cool behind the scenes sort of thing you get to see. Once you come through the door and you take a right, you enter this part. This has been through some changes just because large machines come and go. For example, this is the G-Max 2 Pro right here. I have yet to get it out of the box because I've found a lot of room. There's some machines over there and materials. Here is the Bamboo X1 Carbon with four different AMS units. I'm doing a project with the Hydra mod for that. And the AMS units weren't working right. And so I talked to Bamboo and they're like, oh, yours are too old. And so they're gonna help with that. Let's see. Oh, someone, I forget his name, but sent this. Look at this.
Oh, this is the baby belt.
The baby belt. This is the baby belt 3D printer. So I do have that. There's a P1P, big Raise 3D Pro 3. There's a G-Max 2 still. Oh, my Mark Forge machine is up here. I had to move it up here temporarily to make some room for the Bamboo. Remember that I told you about that resin room? Here, follow me. It doesn't smell too bad. It doesn't just smell too bad because the Anycubic and the Saturn both have those air filters inside of them and they help quite a bit. But I've got my Nexus Zip, Prusa SL1S, a few different machines, even some in boxes that I haven't taken out. This has kind of been the resin room. And part of the reason why I like this is because I've got a comfy chair. I'm careful with the carpet, but I can take my time with prints to slowly snip off supports and slowly sand and just make them look great. And so you get something like that. Oh no, I forgot to glue her hand on, but you get Kim the Mechanic. I know a lot of people print practical things and I know a lot of people print technical things. I like it all, including stuff like this. I think it just looks amazing. This was modeled by Printed Obsession and available via the Photos Mint Patreon. If you're not a member, I highly suggest you take a look. That though is really it.
Hey Joel, I just remembered one thing about the studio tour we forgot to discuss.
What's that?
Your camera setup for what you film your videos with.
This is where I shout at a camera. I've got two Godox LED panels on that side. My A-cam is right here. It is a Blackmagic Pocket Cinema 6K camera. I've got an EF 24-70 Canon lens on it. I record via USB-C to an SSD and I shoot in B-RAW. My B cam and the camera that you see at shows and conventions is the Canon C70. And on this, I've got a 24-105 RF lens. I shoot to this Sony card. What is it called? It's like the super fast one. See, it's got the extra set of pins.
Yeah, UHS-II.
UHS-II, see? Mandic knows. And on there, I've just got a simple Rode mic. It's better than the onboard mics. And so I pick up decent sounds with that. So then for audio, typically, well, at least right now, what I do is I record on this. This is a Zoom F6. It provides 32-bit float audio. So if you scream or if you whisper, it can pick it all up and you can adjust it. It won't clip and it won't bottom out. And I've got two Sennheiser AVX receivers here. I've got the transmitters here. On this one, I use a Sennheiser MKE2 lav mic. Mandic really has a, what'd you have? You had a, right down here. You had a Rode mic. Yeah, a Rode lav mic, and it worked well. This one picks up the tones of my voice a little bit better. I like it better. For up close stuff, I'll shoot it with the Canon R5. Now it'll do 8K video. I have to shoot to a
CF Express.
It's not in there. I was looking for it. I think it's over at my computer. So I shoot to the CF Express 8K video, and then I can really push in, especially if it's locked off on sticks. I can get at it really nice with the tripod. And it gives me the ability to push in. So if I'm doing, like, if you're filming B-roll of something that you've printed, you can get it in 8K, and then it gives you the ability to not just push in, but reframe the shot, and you can get extra sequences out of the same B-roll footage. Oh, look at this. I have a nice iFootage monopod, and on that is a GoPro. And this is what I use to time-lapse lots of things. Also not pictured is a DJI Pocket 2. I've used that to film some stuff. The GoPro, actually, we filmed multiple episodes from Formnext in Germany just with this GoPro Hero 11. Yeah, that's, let's see, what else do I use? Okay, we talked about the F6, the C70, the Blackmagic 6K, the lav mics, the Sennheiser AVX system. I think that's it.
Woo!
Not a lot here. So we make do with 1,000 square feet. As you can see, we try to go higher with some things, but when you have machines like the G Max or the Pro 3 from Raise 3D, you end up with, you can't go too high. You also have power requirements to take into account. Plus, it's a studio, it's a print farm, but I like to set my laptop somewhere and be able to work on some stuff while, you know, I'm eating my lunch or whatever. That's a tour. That's a tour of the 3D Printing Nerd Seattle studio. I hope you enjoyed it. This was a lot of fun. Alan, did you have fun?
I've had a blast.
Alan had a blast. Yeah, I don't, whatever's next, I don't know, but I hope you come along for the journey. You can look for 3D Printing Nerd on all the socials. You can find me online at Joel Telling. That works too. This was fun giving you a tour. I really enjoyed myself and I hope you enjoyed it too.
And that's it for a tour of the 3D Printing Nerd studio. It was a little hectic as we had to wrap it up at the end of the day, right before I hit the road. But thank you so much to Joel for having all of us here to show us around this place. Link to the description down below if you actually don't know who 3D Printing Nerds is for some reason. And be sure to subscribe to this channel to ensure your 3D prints don't fail. It's not a guarantee, but it can't hurt.
I mean, you can... I mean, the fact that you can print that much of a flexible TPU thing.
Like you said, my version of therapy is different than yours.